President Xi Jinping gave China's position very clear. That is, China stands for peace, opposes war. China is a peace-loving country.
That's exactly what the White House is saying, that you are in such a position of power here to pick up the phone and call Vladimir Putin. Has Xi Jinping, your president, told Vladimir Putin to stop the invasion? Do you condemn it?
Actually, on the second day of Russia's military operation, President Xi Jinping did talk to President Putin.
Was that their last
asking moment? President Putin to think about resuming peace talks with Ukraine. And President Putin listened to it, and we have seen four rounds of peace talks have happened. Let me continue. China's trusted relations with Russia is not a liability. Actually, it's an asset in the international efforts to solve the crisis in a peaceful way. And China is part of the solution. It's not part of the problem.
So are you saying, though, just so we're clear, are you saying Beijing will not provide financial support to Moscow to prolong this war?
China has normal trade, economic, financial, energy cooperation with Russia. As I said just now.
So it's not changing. You're not changing your relationship.
These are the normal business between our two sovereign countries.
Let's talk about those international laws, because 4 days ago, the International Court of Justice ordered Russia to stop its military actions. Mm-hmm. China abstained from that. The vote was 13-2. Mm-hmm. The only country that stood next to Russia was China. Well, that sounds like you are condoning and not condemning.
China makes its observation and conclusion based independently, based on the merits of the matter itself.
And we are in the opinion. Would you be concerned if Russia amassed more than 150,000 troops at China's border?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's why we want
just to be clear,
to have a
China,
good,
you would,
good
you would,
friendly, good neighborly relations with Russia.
But you would recognize and what it's not good, friendly, neighborly relations to put 150,000 troops on the border of a neighboring country and then to send those troops into that country.
Yeah.
In those circumstances, why can't you condemn this as an invasion?
Mm-hmm. Well, don't be naive. Condemnation.
It sounds naive to say that's not an invasion.
It doesn't solve the problem.
I
would be surprised if Russia will back down by condemnation. What is urgently needed?
Will they back down if your president asks Vladimir Putin to back down? Will your president ask Vladimir Putin to back
down? We have done so.
They were
and we will continue to promote peace talks and urge immediate fire. And condemnation only doesn't help. We need wisdom. We need courage, and we need good diplomacy.